Hello, Space Lab. I'm Maryam Modjaz. I'm Assistant Professor of Astrophysics at the Center for Cosmology and Particle Physics at New York University. And I'm here to answer your questions. The first question is, if you were standing near the event horizon of a black hole and someone pointed a beam of gamma rays at you, would they remain gamma rays or turn into something else? The short answer is that the gamma rays will turn into light that has longer wavelengths, for example, radio waves. And that has to do with an effect that happens near black holes where gravity is very extreme. So if you imagine gravity as a rubber sheet around a massive object, that space-time will be dented. And when you have light that's trying to climb out of that dent, it becomes light at a longer wavelength. That's called gravitational redshift, something that Einstein theorized in the 1920s, and for which we have a lot of evidence. So in summary, the light that would be shown near the event horizon of a black hole will no longer remain gamma rays, but will be light at longer wavelengths, for example, radio waves. The second question is, in about 3 billion years, the Milky Way and Andromeda galaxy will collide. When that happens, would it affect the size of the black holes in the centers of the two galaxies? Would the two black holes band together to create a bigger one? Most likely, yes. When Andromeda and the Milky Way collide, their central supermassive black holes will most likely also merge and create a larger supermassive black hole. We know that our own galaxy has a supermassive black hole of around 4 million solar masses, but we're not fully certain if also Andromeda has a similar black hole and how its mass is, how big its mass is. So given some of the uncertainties and some of the work that people are doing, though it does look very likely that at around 4 billion years during the merger of the two galaxies, the central supermassive black hole will create a larger supermassive black hole and the two galaxies will create a new galaxy which is more elliptical compared to the galaxies we have now, which are more spiral galaxies. So you might be wondering what might happen to our own solar system once the Milky Way and Andromeda collide. Will our Sun be colliding with another star from the Andromeda galaxy? Well, the answer is no. It turns out distances between stars are huge. So our next star, our neighbor star, is around 4 light years away. And during the collision of the two galaxies, our own solar system will stay intact. Our own Sun will not collide with another star, but our solar system might have a different orbit in this new galaxy. And the natural consequence of the collision between the Milky Way and Andromeda will be that our night sky will be very different. We will not be seeing a band of the Milky Way as we're doing now, but the whole sky will be filled with stars from our own Milky Way as well as from Andromeda galaxy. The final question is, if a planet was orbiting a binary star and traversed between the two stars, would it be ripped apart? If so, what would the experience be if you were standing near the fracture? That's a very interesting question. The short answer is that nothing much will happen. The gravitational forces acting on that planet will be there by the two stars, but in most likelihood, it will not be so strong as to fracture anything. And we astronomers actually believe that it's very hard to form a planet that would then traverse between the two stars. The exoplanets astronomers have found, the three cases so far, they have planets that orbit the double star system but do not traverse between the two stars. Planets form by stuff that's very small sticking together to make bigger things, and then gravity can start acting and more stuff can adhere to it because of gravity. It's really hard to grow a planet out of stuff that's moving between two stars because the stuff will feel the forces of gravity of those two stars. These were all great questions. If you have more questions you want to ask the next expert, please leave them in the comments below.